ओके बेटा, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट चैप्टर. नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ फाइनल अकाउंट. ओके, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ फाइनल अकाउंट? एडजस्टमेंट मींस इफ एनी टाइप ऑफ इनकम, एक्सपेंडिचर, डिप्रिसिएशन, एनीथिंग इफ वी इग्नोर आर नॉट एबल टू डू ऑन द टाइम ऑफ डूइंग द एंट्री, तो व्हेन दैट विल फाइंड ऑन द टाइम ऑफ मेकिंग अ फाइनल अकाउंट, तो दैट all things are all error or all omission we are going to correct on the time of making of final account, that is called adjustment. Okay beta, when we are going to make the final account and at that time we well known or known about the some fault or some error or some omission of things or some omission of accounts, so that we will utilize on the time of making of final account. For that, what system we are going to apply? That is called what? Adjustment. Okay, beta. That is called adjustment. Clear? Now we are going to start what adjustment we are doing. Okay. Mainly outstanding expense, prepaid expense, accrued income, unaccrued income, depreciation, and bad debts. These are the main adjustment. And today we are going to study about these all. Okay. First we are going to start with the expense. Okay. Just see. What I want to say you all, just see. If we are going to adjust anything, so that will apply, just that will apply in making of PL or making of where? In trial balance. And all the adjustment will just keep in the place in your final account two places. Okay, if any adjustment you are going to do, so that will adjust on the two places. Maybe one in a PL account, second in the balance sheet. Maybe one in a trading account, so then second in balance sheet. Okay, so that will take in the two places. Without that screen on these two places, we don't think we are doing the right things. Okay. But now I'm going to start with that first expense. Okay. How will look the expense? Just think you have to pay the 100 rupees. Okay. You have to pay the 100 rupees. But if you are not paying 100 rupees, you are paying only 90 rupees, or you are paying 110. You are not paying your expense, that is called outstanding. Okay, beta? And you are paying more, that is called prepaid. Okay? Very easy logic. You are not paying means you have to pay. So then you are going to add. Then you are going to add the outstanding. If outstanding expense is given, so then we are going to add that outstanding expense. Prepaid the money, so then less from that related expense. Okay, beta. If outstanding is there, that will add in expense. If prepaid is there, that is a less from expense. Okay. Just see how we are showing this. If you are making the PL account and it's outstanding rent, Okay. So then how open the outstanding? If rent is given, just think about the 800, but then this outstanding, 10 rupees is outstanding because 100 is there, 10 rupees, so 10 rupees add outstanding 10 rupees, so it's 100, 800, 10 rupees. Okay, clear how we are doing? Clear or not? And in the balance sheet, we are showing like that, this side, liability side. Outstanding rent 10 rupees. Okay, clear? It means the expense, outstanding expense will less from the related expense, and that will show on the assets at two places. It will show on the two places. Clear, beta? It's clear? Now we are going for the prepaid. How we are showing the prepaid? Just see. If rent is given, prepaid 10 rupees, so then here rent less prepaid 10 rupees. Less is there 790. And prepaid is two on the asset side. Okay. On this we are showing the outstanding expense and prepaid expense. Expense, beta. Okay. 100 rupees is your main expense, but you are going to pay only 90 rupees. Means 10 rupees remain for paying. That is the outstanding expense. Extra amount you are 10 rupees extra paying. That is the prepaid. Okay. For the outstanding, less add from that related expense and showing on the liability side. For the prepaid, less from the related expense and showing the assets. Okay. Now I'm coming from the income. Let's see. If it's income, 100 rupees main income, but you are receiving only 90, and then you are receiving more. It means 120. Okay? If you are receiving only 90, okay? But it means it's accrued. Okay? You are accrued means you are earned but not received. As like an outstanding, opposite outstanding. Okay, it means unaccrued, accrued, and here and accrued. You are receiving 20 rupees more without doing work. That is the unaccrued, and accrued means when you are received money. When you have to receive money, but you are not receiving the money. You have to receive 100 rupees, but you are receiving only beta 90. 10 rupees remain for receiving. It's accrued. And 20 rupees extra, that is unaccrued. It means as like that, it's what? Outstanding. For that, it's outstanding. We have to receive and that we have received advance, so that will less. It's an advance, it's not received. Means how am I going to do this? Just think about that. Just see. Again, I'm going to make one PL. Maybe it's the if related with the wages or any expense which is showing in a trading account, but these all things is doing a trading account beta. Where that expense is given or income is given, we are going to adjust on that same place. Okay. Here any rent. Okay, rent now income. Rent is the income. Just things, rent is the income. 1000. But 10 rupees we have not received. So then accrued 10 rupees, so 1000, 10 rupees. Okay, and in balance sheet, always all the adjustment will show on the two places. Okay, beta, all the adjustment showing on the two places. And in balance sheet, we are not received, it's accrued income 10 rupees in asset side. Okay, beta, clear? Next. Just see if advance is there. So then, how we are showing for advance? Buy rent 1000 less advance 20 rupees, 9080 rupees. You have received the advance income. Advance income liability side. Okay, beta. On this way, we are presenting. What? Income. Okay? Outstanding, like outstanding are accrued income, and that is the advance income. Okay? Now I'm going for the depreciation. How we are going to show the depreciation? Okay? I think you will remember the depreciation, but you are using that depreciation as an account. Here, how we are showing the depreciation in PL account? It's always showing in PL account. Okay, beta? Here the one fact is very clear. It's shown in a PL account. Just think, if any assets is given, as like a plant, 1 lakh rupees, okay? And depreciation charge 10%, okay? How we are going to present? If depreciation charge given on the outside in additional information and plant is given a trial balance, when we are going to make the PL, let's see how we are going to. So, in PL, we are showing two depreciation. Okay, beta? And then plant. 10%, just calculate 10% beta. 10%, 10,000. That is on the outside. If any other assets given, other assets put here and take the amount outside. Only one. Okay. And then we are going to make the balance sheet beta. We are putting plant assets side. 1 lakh rupees less depreciation. 10,000. And outside. Okay, on this way we are going to present when any adjustment is given for depreciation. Okay, beta, if any adjustment is given for depreciation, so when we are going to put on the this. Okay, clear? On this way we are utilizing all the adjustment. Okay. Clear beta? Up to this is clear? Okay, in next class we are going for the next video. Next class we are going for the next adjustment. Up to this we are going to apply it. Okay, thank you.